So I wanted to do a quick video on reverse Polish notation, just an introduction on how it is implemented on this calculator. Most of us, well, if you're buying this calculator, you probably already know what reverse Polish notation is. But if you're looking at it for something like the PE or the FE, it's good to know. So most of us are familiar with infix notation or algebraic. So if I go to mode here and then pick 4 in algebraic, then I can enter something like 2 times 3 plus 5 times 16, etc. Hit enter, and it gives me the answer. In reverse Polish notation, that would be done. Let's see if we do 2 times 3 plus 6 times 16. Something like that. You'd put in your 2 first, and then hit enter. And you'll see that that bumped it up in the stack here. This is what's called the stack. This is your X register, this is your Y register, and then there's 2 more, a Z and a T register. So I've got 2 in my stack here. I put in my 3, I've got my 2 and my 3, just like here. Now I hit the multiply button, because that's what I want to do with these 2 numbers that are in the stack. And I get 6. For the next segment here, I'm going to hit enter 6, so I've got another 6 in there, hit enter, then 16, multiply those together, and then add my first 6 to my result here, so hit plus. And my final answer is 102. The benefit of this isn't immediately obvious, but it comes when you have longer equations. Say we have something like 1 plus e to the 2 divided by 3 all over, oh, I don't know, 5 halves, something like that. With a typical infix notation or algebraic, you'd have to have parentheses when you enter it. You have to put in parentheses for the numerator, the denominator. In RPN, you would calculate it just as you would if you were to calculate this manually. So you start from the inside out. So I would enter this first. So I'm going to do the decimal fraction. So 2/3. And I would raise e to that number. So blue shift e to the x. Then I'd add 1 to it, so I put in my 1, hit plus, and I'd put in my 5 halves, and then divide that top amount up here by the bottom amount down there. And there's my answer. So because you're fulfilling the role of knowing where the parentheses go mentally, you can move a lot quicker this way, and it makes programming intuitive as well. Now I just want to make a brief note here of several things on the keyboard. Remember, this is the X register, and this is the Y register. So all of these functions here, like the square root of X, refer to the X register. So that would take the square root of what's in the X register. The blue X squared would take the square of what's in the X register. Y to the X, so 10, enter 2, I've got 10 in my Y register, 2 in my X register. So if I hit Y to the X, it would be 10 squared. 100. If I do 1 over X, that is the reciprocal of what's in the X register. And E to the X is the natural number to the power of what is in the X register. Same with square root here. So if I take 100, enter 2, and then take the square root, I'm taking the square root of y, or the xth root of y. In this case, it is the square root since I entered 2. Gold shift, square root 10. A couple other things to note. This swaps what is in the X and the Y register. So say, for example, you had I don't know, 2.5 and then 3.3, and you realized you wanted to divide 3.3 by 2.5 instead of the other way around. So you can swap those two by hitting the X swap Y. And swap those back and forth, and then do your division. Or multiplication. Well, multiplication wouldn't matter. Anyway. The other thing with the stack here is this R down. That means roll down. So say there's a value up somewhere in here in the stack. Well, let me just enter real quick. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4. So I've got 4 values in my stack. If I wanted to roll down and work with the 2, what's currently in the Z value, or Z register, I get the roll down button, and it rolls that stack down. If I keep on pressing it, it rolls all the way back to the beginning. It is circular. And then roll up is the other one. This function here, I can swap in and out of the X register to a variable. So if I've got 1 here, and I want to swap, it says, what do you want to swap the X register with? Let's swap it with what's in A. There probably was nothing in A. But now I've got another number in here, and then I go and I recall what's in A. And what is in A was what was in the X register. Now, let's look at, let's do 2. Swap that with what's in A. Now what was in A was 1, so it comes into the X register. And now if I recall A, 2 comes back. So that's just a quick overview. These keys, the X's, the Y's, are very intuitive once you actually understand what is going on.